Hey, I'm Neely. Navigation is key for your website visitors to find their way around. In this video, I will show you how to make a new menu and add content to that menu. Menus are typically at the top of your website, and the menu is consistent over every page. This helps customers navigate from page to page, and you can create menus that expand into submenus. Let's start on the WordPress dashboard. Select Appearance and then Menus. Depending on your theme, you should see a primary menu here. If you don't have a menu, or if you want to create a new one, select Create New Menu. Let's create a new menu and call it Menu 2. Don't worry about these menu names, visitors can't see them. If you decide that you want this second menu to be your primary menu, select the checkbox for the location that makes the most sense based on your theme. Let's go back to the previous menu by using this dropdown and selecting Primary, then the Select button. Under Add Menu Items, these are all the items you can place in the menu: pages, posts, categories, etc. If you're missing content here, go up to Screen Options. Here you can select or deselect any elements you want for this page. Under Menu Structure, this is the area where we built out the menu using elements from the Items menu. Let's start by adding a few pages to the menu. If you don't see all of your pages, select View All. Now, select Save Menu. Let's go take a look at our menu really quick. Under Appearance, select Customize. With the website preview up, you can see the menu items at the top. Click out of this to return to the dashboard. I want to add a new page in order to have a menu item for my recipes. In the dashboard, select Pages and Add New. Let's just title this Recipes and select Save. Now let's return to the menu section and add this page to our menu. There it is. In a previous video, we worked with categories. With each post, you can assign tags and categories so they are easy to organize and search. I want to add these to my Recipes menu. Select View All and select All, then Add to Menu. Now it's time to organize. I want to put each food category under the recipe page as a submenu. This is a drag and drop, so drag this first category about a half an inch to the right and it will sort of pop into place. Let's do the same with the other food categories. I have two recipes that are specific to Italian, so let's create yet another submenu for these. In this case, we want to align this another half an inch under the Italian category. Once again, it just kind of pops into place. When this looks correct, select Save Menu. Ready to check it out? Go back to the Customize page, and there it is. The dropdown is working for the categories and subcategories. If we had content tagged for lasagna, selecting this menu item would bring up a page listing all of the content with that tag. In the customizer, select Menus. Select Primary Menu. You can make changes to the menu here as well. For example, if you want to move the Recipes tab, just drag it to the spot desired and it will update in real time. But don't forget to publish. That's it for menu basics. If you dig around, I'm sure you can discover more ways to get creative with menus and navigation. Thanks for watching.